Hi everybody, I am Lady Stars and Fire, and this is the weekly healing messages, or weekly reading, however you want to see it, for August 22nd until the 29th. Now, before I go into any further information, I always call it the healing messages, specifically because that's what I'm asking for. I'm asking for them to give us guidance that will help us move forward in the most positive healing ways throughout our life for this upcoming week, for any and all who are willing to listen to the healing messages. And I give it from a little bit of information from what it is that Spirit gives me with a little bit of astrology, and then I go into the rune cast. So I give you a little bit of a 3 for 3 of the information that I am giving. Now, you see that I'm in the woods because I was pulled out here to the woods specifically to find a spider web right there, which is reminding you right from the break, pay attention to the web you're spinning right now. Pay attention to the web you're spinning. Okay, we just had the full moon with that eclipse. Now, I never brought up the eclipse before because I wasn't sure, outside of eclipse are always about change, what exactly it was that was meaning. I wasn't getting that greater scale, or how big of a greater scale all of that was. And that's a good thing, because when we have the eclipse, what's going on is, with the full moon, not the eclipse, when we get the full moon, it's all about bringing things to light that need to change. But the eclipse did it on a massive, larger scale. And it plays in a different way that I've got a little bit more information to explain to you now. But when we have that full moon, it brings information to light of what needs to change. And right now, we're in that like 2-week period of between the full moon and the new moon. So we're starting to make those changes, so to speak, so that our new beginnings can start, our new goals, our new projects can actually start. Now, the thing is if you actually follow the healing messages, approximately 3 weeks ago, I came out and I said that the Egyptian goddess Isis stood forward and started to the left. And what that was telling me when she was coming was she is the goddess of health, healing, as well as magic. She's coming to the left, which is telling us it's all about soul. So that was going to be going on with us, along with she was bringing a snake. And the snake was telling us that we're going inwardly, and basically we were shedding our skin. And I had said at that point that we were going to be in stillness for a little while we underwent all of that. Then I also stated that I thought that this was going to take approximately about 3 months before everything was done. And I also had stated, because it's coming to light, I understand it better now, that what it has to do with is, I had stated it was something to do with like our DNA, like our spiral of our DNA. Not that there's anything wrong with us in general, but it was like being recalculated, our internal makeup was being redesigned, so to speak. And what it is our negativities, our residual energy that's not good for us, it's being pulled out, being corrected, being cleaned. And this has changed us in major ways over this past 3 weeks. And that had to do with that eclipse coming in, because it's bringing major changes for the new. It's, like I said, it's your residual energy that is being cleaned out. So we're getting a reset, a shift, basically, in everything that we've known prior. If you know of past lives, basically, I don't know how else to put that. If you know of your past lives, you may have been revisiting them. Even if it's in this life, a past life, it's still something that is no more. But if you have real past lives that you knew about, you may be revisiting them. You may be seeing them in dreams. Stuff like that might have been coming up. And this is part of that residual DNA that's in you. You're cleaning that out. You're letting that go. You're no longer carrying any of that with you. That's what this eclipse is about. It's giving us a reset, a new start, a start over. Basically, have you been feeling nostalgic lately? Have you been feeling that information in dreams coming out. All of that is like revisiting of your past. So whether it was of past lives or past life within this life, either way, you're been revisiting them because you have a reason for it. You've been seeing them. Plus Mercury retrograde is coming in at the end of this week on the 30th. So we've been in shadow. Mercury is our communicator. It is like our computer, basically. It's our messaging system to the outside world, normally. And when it's in shadow, it's showing us things that didn't work out, kind of wasn't good for us. And so it's bringing us that darker side. But when it goes into retrograde, it turns and it's evaluating from the inside. So what messages did it that you just didn't get? What was you refusing to get? What memo to yourself was you refusing to hear? That is part of Mercury retrograde. This is what I'm being told by spirit. See, because as we're in this shadow, we're evaluating these things for that letting go. We're in that stasis. We're in that stillness period, because it has everything to do with that moment of stillness has everything to do with our inner nourishment and strengthening of our inner resources. However, as we are redesigning our inner makeup, so to speak, we are also feeling, a lot of us have been, I put out a thing the other day on Facebook saying that a lot of us are noticing, for no reason at all, really, it isn't not anything that we've been eating or anything, we've either had a lot of bad headaches or heartburn or bloating, gas, back pain. And this is our chakras trying to come into balance and clean themselves, basically. So it's that releasing of all of that energy. But as it cleans itself, they're trying to come into a new, even balance on their own without your help. And this has to do a lot with all that residual energy finally just releasing itself from our system, from our self in itself. We're, like I said, we're getting a reset. We're getting a start over. We're getting a redo, basically. And it's a wonderful thing. However, we are still going to be in that stasis period for, you know, at least until we're through Mercury retrograde. So we're kind of in that stillness of the moment, that inner nourishment, that strengthening of our resources. And I am being told, along with getting that new slate, sorry, I'm outside, you got a lot of animals. we are actually getting the opportunity to set new impressions that can last lifetimes, honey. That is awesome. But again, like I was brought all the way down here to look at the spider web to remind you what it is you are creating. Pay attention to the web you are spinning for yourself. Also, right before I came down here, I had a dragonfly fly around me 3 times right before I came down this path to see what I was being drawn for. So there's many different things. Always remember, life is basically a gift. So even when you're not understanding it, accept it with gratitude. It helps. And I'm also being told as we move forward to also remember that our power, our true strength comes from within, but it also comes from our own knowledge, our own experience. And with that, we can then grow into a stronger power of abundance and never forget that. However, being grateful and showing gratitude always strengthens that. Now, we start off the week in Taurus. Taurus is solid, sensual, secure, and it's comfortable. It's relaxed. But we kind of resist change when we are in Taurus. And that's fine, unless it's really needed. I mean, because Taurus is the bull. It can be bullheaded. And bullheadedness can go very well in either direction. You can be bullheaded for ignorant reasons, or you can be bullheaded for the right reasons. So just make sure you're paying attention to where your bullheadedness is coming in with that solid, sensual, and secure feelings that you have going on right now. Because, like I said, we tend to resist change in Taurus. Then we move into Gemini. Gemini, throughout the middle of the week, is restless. We get into that word game, riddles. The words that we speak are very important, powerful words. Every time you say I am in front of something, you're creating a spell for yourself. Basically, you have no idea how much power is in your own words, along with your own belief, because your soul hears it. So never forget that. But we also become, in Gemini, a little scattered, not exactly satisfied. We want the shortcut. We want the short trips. So you got to pay attention to that, that you're not taking it in a way that's not positive for you. Then we move into Cancer. Cancer is nourishing. I'm going to learn how to talk one day. And it's nourishing of our family, of our loved ones in general. We express our emotions. We become sympathetic. We are very high emotional, but we can become oversensitive. We can become dependent, and we can become needy. So you want to watch out for that as well as we approach the end of the week. Now, on the 22nd, the 22nd also is one of my big numbers. It is always given to me over and over again with the fact that it has to do with harmony and finding balance. And on the 22nd, the sun moves into Virgo. The sun is our executive director, period. It is our core. Everything about us comes from the sun within us. It's the final decision. It is our inner goal. Our inner goal for the sun, period, is we want to shine. So how is it that we can shine to the outside world? I'm in the wrong place. It is our pride, our inner confidence, and our identity. Sun is everything that is now. It's the attention that's given to us now, basically. Heart. It is our heart, it is our upper back, and it is our circular system. And when we move that, all of that sun energy, all of that executive director, how do we shine? How do we send that out to the outside world? It is our now attention period. We're moving it into Virgo. Virgo is picky. It is critical. It is where we critique. It is where we analyze, where we organize and we fix things. It also deals with our own personal health as well. But it's also ruled by Mercury. See, all of this is happening with that eclipse on purpose at a specific time for us to get that restart, for us to get that start over, reset. And like I said, it's the opportunity being given to us to actually be able to set impressions that last lifetimes. Now give me a second so I can get the runes. I tripped. Okay. We start off with the runes because the very first thing that's coming to us is Birkena. Birkena is coming in Muggle Stone. It is coming in Muggle Stone. It is our grounding stone. It is our empathic stone. It is our separating of energy stone, as well as it is all about creativity. Birkena is the birch tree. It is fertility. It is beginnings. This is saying for an overall is what they're giving me the Birkena is. It points to women. It points to the goddess and the magic of the goddess. It is women's history, mysteries and issues. Women's feminine mysteries and issues like birth. It is all about new beginnings with fertility and cleaning, basically. It's principle of fertility, new life. Release following a period of gestation. Like I said, we're in that stasis right now of Birkena. It is preparation for those new starts, those new beginnings, based off of those old patterns. Growth through carrying intuition, rebirth, now becoming into that hero. You know, when you was a child, you could think of being that superhero and you could play it out and you hadn't been screwed up by the world and lost the chance to still dream. That's what this is. You're getting that restart to be exactly who and what it is you want. But like the spider web says, pay attention to the web that you are spinning. It is the goddess made manifested. It is exorcism itself. Releasing of what is no longer good for you. See, this is what I'm saying. You're still going to see those negativities because it is that breaking ground. It is that rebirth time. But we still are seeing those because we're letting that go. The final release of it. Now, hold on. I can give the next one. It is, Tuaz. Tuaz is coming in truth and, in awareness, calming energy, as well as spiritual energy. It also showed up in another stone, which is my Rodonite for unconditional love, love of self, love of others. Tuaz is the god. It is the sky. It is the polar star. It is order. It is the mineral world, and it is air. It focuses on matters of adherence to principle, victory through wisdom, and social order of justice. It is honor. It is justice. It is leadership. It is analysis, and it is rationality. It points to the need for that seasoned approach right now. Again, it is social order, law, justice, our polar star. It is our personal sacrifices. It is the notion of our own independence. It is order of existence to which it is that we all belong. It is cooperating, cooperating by division into separate working units. It is the necessary protocol for loyalty and faith in principle. It is that oath taking for analysis, method, courage, planning, precision. It is also military action. It is also victory. It is also victory in battle and weaponry. It is objective judgment. Social discipline leads to self-discipline. Social discipline leading to self-discipline. And lastly, we have Asus. No. Awaz, sorry, we have Awaz, and it's coming in truth and honesty. And Awaz is the twin. It is horses. It is the twin horses. It is partnership. It is earth. It is the animal world. It is a moment of change being given to you for the better. It points towards teamwork, towards cooperation, working in harmony, shared endeavors, union, erotic, coupling even, are all of its focuses. It is often considered the marriage, but don't get it wrong. I say this every time because there's those out there who are like, but you said marriage. No, it is marrying, not necessarily marriage. Now that might be the situation for you, but that's not necessarily the only route they're taking. They could be talking about the marrying of your own work, of new, situations like within work environment or partnerships with other people, of friendships, of relationships of different kinds, family even, partnering in some endeavor, more or less. It can indicate the presence of a spouse, like I said, or a marriage, or it can also show or reveal a journey into an unseen world. It can reveal also the journey into the unseen world and the means in which to make that journey. Right there is what we're talking about this time. It is also the ability to reveal a means into a new journey into an unseen world and the means to be able to make that journey is what you're going to start to be coming in to see. But it is also about partnership, cooperation, union, the horse and the rider. It is the give and take. It is adjustments to the needs of others. It is meetings. It is joint efforts. It is teamwork. It's running in tandem. It is harmony itself. It is active bonding, also coupling and marriage. Attraction of the opposites. Respecting different differences. It is the female side meeting and coming into balance with the male side, your feminine and your masculine. And that's it. It's also saying it may be also showing you of a vehicle of otherworldly journeys in general. I love you. I hope that you have a wonderful week. Remember to take it easy on yourself because you are still cleaning out a lot of energy. And hugs and kisses. And also, don't forget to check out Sacred Grove Radio. I have two shows there, Getting Familiar and Shamanic Gateways, on Thursday and Friday nights at 8 o'clock. So you can always check me out there too. Otherwise, I'll see you later. Or you can visit me and recheck out the reading and the healing messages if you want to come back to them at my website, ladystarsandfire.com. Bye, everybody. I hope you have a wonderful week.